bloodshed, loneliness, and fear created this land. We built America, and the process made us Americans. A new breed, rooted in all races, stained and tinted with all colors, a seeming ethnic anarchy. Then, in a bit of time, we became more alike than we were different. A new society. Not great, but fitted by our very thoughts for greatness. Excuse me, Mr. Twain. Perhaps you recognize those inspiring words from one of America's great writers.
No, Dr. Franklin, I don't recall writing anything like that.
Oh, my, of course not. They're from the pen of John Steinbeck, back in the 20th century. Why, it seems he has nearly the same spirit as the founding fathers themselves.
Well, listen to the proud elder statesman.
Mr. Twain, pride is one of our national passions. Even those who overcome it are proud of their humility.
Easy now. I was born modest. Fortunately, more often. Dr. Franklin is a genuine American antique. I suppose our story begins with you.
Actually, it started long before even my time. It started when dreams and visions of a new world were shrouded in the myths and legends of an old world. Finally, through those early mists of uncertainty, sailed the first great adventurers. This tiny ship is the Mayflower, carrying pilgrims in search of their dream, a dream of religious freedom. So, if you pardon an old man's pride, for me, this is the beginning of the American adventure.
Finally, the time had come to speak with one voice.
voice in a declaration of independence. Good evening, Mr. Jefferson. Have you finished the new draft yet?
Those are new drafts all over the floor, Dr. Franklin. It seems one stroke of this pen brings two changes from Congress. I told you John Adams should have written this.
Oh, by his own admission, you can write circles around him.
Mr. Adams has not been prisoner in this law for 17 days. I shall continue tomorrow.
You must continue now. Count, it is difficult to make 13 clocks chime at the same time. You must carefully justify the separation.
Dr. Franklin, while you slept soundly through the meeting this afternoon, we did manage to justify separation. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And to secure these rights,
troublemaker. Americans like Douglas got us into this mess.
He only wanted freedom, not war.
Well, listen to my abolitionist brother.
What?
He's gonna make a real good Philly Yankee.
We got a good call, Johnny Graham.
What? Oh, look here. You're gonna ruin Ma's birthday.
No. Ain't nothing gonna ruin today. We're all together. That's what counts. Now, you go ahead, Mr. Brady.
All right, everybody. Hold real still.
Build a new concert hall for New York.
Carnegie Hall, eh? And nevertheless, donating libraries. Andy, that's grand ideas.
It's an age for grand ideas. An era for innovation.
A dawn for new awareness.
A time to challenge the frontier to the new century.
Folks could use a little trial. around these parts, Julie.
Yes, sir. Before this depression, we sure had enjoyed special lessons.
Oh,
but you know, it seems to me that
it was a mighty cocky nation. We begun to believe that the height of civilization was an automobile, a radio, and a bathroom. Of course, now we're a whole lot smarter. Now Congress wants to trim down the Navy so it'll fit into the bathtub, too. You know, it seems to me like we're the only nation in the world that waits till we get in the war before we start getting ready for it.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked.
Hey!
Mr. Twain, what do you think of our America now?
I think the Founding Fathers never dreamed of an America like this.
Of course not. We weren't dreamers. We were visionaries. That is why our Constitution withstands the rigors of time.
Easy now, Dr. Franklin. This nation's still just a youngster, don't you know? Why, some countries have been around for 50 centuries. We're barely into a third.
That's true. But look what we've accomplished in that tiny span of time.
My dear doctor, earlier you found John Steinbeck so inspiring. But he also sounded this warning. We now face the danger which in the past has been the most destructive to the human. Success, plenty, comfort, and ever-increasing leisure. No dynamic people has ever survived these dangers.
I may have invented these bifocals, I'm wearing, but I can assure you they are not rose-colored. Mr. Twain, the golden age never was the present age, but with human liberty, we can fulfill the promise and meaning of America. To everyone a chance, believed Thomas Wolfe. To all people, regardless of their birth, the right to live, to work, to be themselves, and to become whatever their visions can combine to make them. This is the promise of America. Mr. Twain, 'tis easy to see, hard to foresee, but I foresee the American adventure to continue a long, long time.
Guys enjoyed, be sure to like and subscribe. See you real soon.